Failure of long cylinder columns under compressive load is called buckling, and the peak load at which buckling is produced in columns is called critical buckling load. The critical buckling load is found by Euler's column formula. In this formula, the N is factor accounting for the end conditions, E is modulus of elasticity, I is moment of inertia, and L is length of the beam. The figure shows us different end conditions of beam loading, and in the first case we can see here that there are roller supports on both ends. For this case, N is equal to 1. In the second case, and the both ends are fixed supported and the value of N is equal to 4. In the third case, the one end is fixed supported and the other is roller supported. For this case, N is equal to 2. And the last case, where one end is fixed and the other end is free, the value of N is equal to 0.25. In this tutorial, we will perform buckling load analysis on a beam. This beam has a material of stainless steel, and its dimensions are taken from a website engineering toolbox. These are the dimensions which were taken from engineering toolbox. Let's go to the website. This is the website engineering toolbox, and we have picked the first beam. We can choose any beam for our analysis, but I have chosen the first one. Its depth is 27.8, width is 14.09, web thickness is 0.725, and flange thickness is 1.19. These dimensions will be used to create the geometry, and the moment of inertia is along y-axis is 555. So now we go back to our presentation. Here we have this depth of this beam. This is the depth of beam is 27.8. width of this beam, this is the width, y is 14.09. this is web thickness is 0.725, and this is flange thickness. This is, here we can see that this is flange thickness, this is 1.19. then we will use modulus of Young's modulus, which value is 0.9 into 10 raised to power 7 for steel, and moment of inertia along y section of this beam is 555, and value of N is 0.25, because we will take one end of this beam to be fixed and the other end will be free, so value of N will be 0.25. now we go to Ansys program. This is Ansys workbench. Now open Ansys and drag static structural to project schematic, and then eigenvalue buckling on the model cell of static structural. Drop it here and then connect the solution cell to the setup cell of eigenvalue buckling analysis. After this, I will confirm that my material is structural steel and its Young's modulus is the value that was previously defined. I will change the units, which is I'll change it to US customary units, and then I'll confirm here that I can see here that Young's modulus is 2.9 into 10 raised to power 7, and I'll close the engineering data. Then double click geometry, it will start. It will give us a message starting space claim. In the older versions of Ansys workbench, design modeler was used to create geometry, but I'm using Ansys 17.2. It uses space claim to create the geometry. So it is now opened. I want to create the geometry in X, Y plane. I click on button sketch new plane, select new sketch plane, and then I select XY plane, and then plane, click on the plane view to look at the plane. Then I want to change the units. I go to space claim options, units, and then from type tab I will change it to imperial and OK. Then I will select a line, click on the origin, and the line width is 14.09. that is flange width of the beam. Then a vertical line having length 1.19, that is flange thickness. Then this horizontal line is equal to the total width of the flange minus the web thickness. So if we go back to our presentation, total width of the flange was 14.09 and web thickness was 0.725. So it is 14.09 minus 0.725 divided by 2. It is 6.6825. So the length is 6.6825, and then height, which is the depth of this beam, it is equal to the total depth minus the flange thickness. You can see here that total depth is 27.8, and if we subtract the flange thickness twice from this total depth, we will get the inside depth of this line. So open the calculator. 27.8 minus 1.19 flange thickness, again subtract 1.19, so we get the value 25.42. we will use this value. 25.42. we'll press Z button to zoom in, and then horizontal line equals, we can see here that software is showing us that our length is equal. So we thus press the left mouse button, and then vertical line having length 1.19, then horizontal line having length 14.09, then downward vertical line having length 1.19, then horizontal line having length of 6.6825, then a downward line having length 25.4. Now the sketch is complete. Now we press on the pull button. It will create a closed surface. Then we go press this trimetric button to see a 3D view. Then we'll drag this, we'll we select this surface, press ruler button and enter a value of 300. So we have now created our beam having extrusion length of 300 inches. Then we minimize it, then double click on the model button, start mechanical solver. It will take few seconds to open up and load the geometry. The first thing we will do is to create the mesh. Click on the mesh button and then sizing, relevant center, change the relevant center from coarse to fine. Then right click on the mesh, generate mesh. Then click on the static structure, right click, insert, and right click, insert, fix support, then click on this face and then apply, and this face is now fix supported. On the other end we will apply force, so press the rotate button and select this face. Click the face selection button, then select the face, then right click on static structural, insert, force, and this face is automatically applied here. Then we'll define the force by components and enter in the Z component 1. 1 pound is the force. So now we see the direction of force is towards the positive Z direction, which is a compressive force to the beam. Then click the solution tab, right click, insert, deformation, total deformation. Then the solution tab of eigenvalue buckling, right click, insert, deformation, total deformation. Then we will solve the analysis. It will give us a load multiplier, which will be the critical load for this beam, particular beam having length of 300 inches and having material of steel, and it will tell us how much critical load, compressive load is required to buckle this beam. So we will later validate our results with the hand calculations, and we'll see that how much close we are in our calculations. So it is almost complete now. So if we see in the total deformation, we have get a value of 4.6397 into 10 raised to power 5. So this is the load multiplier. We have applied a force of 1 pound and we have obtained a load multiplier which is equal to 4.6. So we go for our hand calculations and see how much close we are. So in our hand calculations, we have the value of n is 0.25, 3.14 is value of pi, e is 2.9 into 10 raised to the power 7, I is moment of inertia is 555 and L is 300. So we get 4.408. So we are pretty close. The numerical results are acceptable, we can say that. And if we change the force from 1 pound to 100,000 pounds, so it will solve again. It will show that how much the beam will be deflected under 100,000 pounds force. So we see now the total deformation is given in feet. We may change it into millimeters from changing the units here. So the total deformation is now 0.49 mm. Change the units back to US customary, and now we'll see the deformation. We solve this one as well. So solution is complete. We can see now the load multiplier is now reduced to 4.6. we can say it that it is a factor of safety. So at the value of 463,970 pounds force, this beam will buckle. So we see now the deflection of beam, how it is buckling. So we have two values of load multiplier. We can see, we can also see the second load multiplier, and click on this and create mode shape results. So it will give us a second mode shape. So we can see this is the second mode shape at a load of 18.755 times 100,000. So this is the second mode shape. We can take pictures by clicking on this button, new figure or image. Click this button and we'll press this image to clipboard. We can now paste this image to our report wherever we want. So this is it. I hope you have get understanding of how to find the critical buckling load of for a particular beam. Thank you very much.